I'm sitting in a corner of a special block of food. It's kind of like a food court in an old-fashioned district where it's a full strip of mainly food resources and vendors of food, predominantly small business owners and mostly local business owners. Only a couple chains exist. We thankfully have a Dunkin' Donuts. We also have a Panera. Unfortunately, at the present moment, neither of them are open, so they're sort of missing out on some of the business as people are coming out more and more every single day to be in the world and not of the world, I suppose you could say. But on this block, there are two companies in particular, one international and one local, that are worthy of esteem. It's amazing what this health crisis has done to the international company's employee, their mentality, their customer service quality, and everything, but I cannot say enough about this local McDonald's. Not only are their people good people, they are highly professional, they do their job well, but they're incredibly kind and incredibly compassionate. They have been very loving and kind to an old man who has to schlep his stuff around because the Lord requires him to be prepared to give the gifts that he receives to those in need. In the name of McDonald's, I can say that there are several employees in particular who are excellent, and I do my best, like most people should, as any consumer of any international or national chain, to let those corporations know that they have quality people in place. It's so hard today to find a good retail establishment where the employees don't steal, where the employees don't lie, where the employees don't disadvantage the company by being foolish or immature. A few months ago, I might have said otherwise, but the late shift here at McDonald's is very good. The morning shift has good quality. People work hard, they do their job efficiently, and they have handled the efficiency of not being able to allow people to dine in extremely well. Whoever put in place that efficiency process did an excellent job. Unlike some of the huger places like Meijer and others that put these ridiculous lines that people have to dive around and walk an extra mile around just to get in the store, this little McDonald's has done a great job. Across the street, down the block, is a wonderful teeny little restaurant. I want to tell you about it because not of its incredible capabilities to serve lots of people, but because of its wonderful staff, its excellent, incredibly healthy food, and it's totally worthy of everyone's dollars. It's called Mia Zai's. They prepare Italian food right there in front of your eyes. They openly will do it in a matter of 5 or 10 minutes. They prepare great flatbread pizzas and wonderful zucchini-type spaghettis and other types of fettuccines, which I haven't sampled everything. They also have exceptionally good sandwiches, and openly, I'm more than impressed with how loving and kind the owner and its staff has been to an old man. They have willingly and always been welcoming late at night to allow me to have water. And on this block, the two purest places to receive water are Mia Zai's and then a little place down the way called Wings Out. Both have extremely good machines that provide extremely good type of clean water. Uncompared to other places where when you push the water button, the water comes out with some discolor because, of course, it's sharing a pump with a flavored punch or some sort of lemonade. In truth, there are moments of time to tell a good story, and I really want to encourage the people of Champaign to shop at Mia Zai's. I really want to encourage people of Champaign to frequent the local McDonald's. I really want to encourage people to utilize those companies when they have parties, when they have kids' events, or in particular with the Italian place. I really want to encourage you to utilize it for upcoming wedding showers, upcoming bridal parties, upcoming premarital dinners, which I forget, rehearsal dinners, sorry, I almost lost the English word for it. But openly, they can also cater weddings, and I'd like to highly encourage you to do that. In the name of God, we go to a lot of places, but in the name of ourselves, we invade people's privacy and we do things that's not right. These people have done nothing of the kind. They openly have simply said, this guy's in struggle right now, he will not always be in struggle, and they have done nothing at all malicious to interfere with an old man's right to sit down when he's tired. I carry probably 40 to 50 pounds of materials with me that God directs me to, that he helps me to find, that I lovingly give to people who he says to give them to. And it's always amazing how quickly the person is willing to receive the items of quality and value that I've cleansed, that I've sanitized, and I've provided to them. It's also amazing how many times my property that I've set down someplace because I couldn't carry it all, after carrying it through the night using unique formats and unique lifts and unique ways of bringing it across town, that someone has stolen it. I literally find things that people are no longer using, that don't belong in our earth, that don't belong in our recycle, in the way that people are recycling locally, and I have given those things away, but I've also had them stolen, which says that they are quality items. In life, I just want to share this part of my life, because without these kind people, there would be no place for a homeless person like me to receive water. I'm also not a nuisance to them. I don't solicit their patrons. I don't interfere with their life. I don't do anything other than benefit from the kindness of them, and I will be a loyal customer the rest of my life. And my prayer is you will find them just as wonderful, just as willing to serve you, and just as great to give your money and hard-earned discretionary income to. There are moments of time where we tell a true story, and I can tell you there are others on the block that are vile and horrible to people like me. And I'm only going to say that so that you're careful of where you put your money. Because if, God forbid, your life gets hit by cybercrime or identity theft like mine, if your life gets hit by people who lie, steal, and cheat you out of your rightful goods, your rightful paperwork, your rightful property, I'd like to know that you would also find loving kindness around you in your neighborhood and your community. But that's not always the case. There are many retail people who are close to the poverty line, and they struggle with giving up something that they have to pay for, even if it's at a modest rate. In truth, it's always about the soul of the person and what they acknowledge, what they respond to, and not everyone believes that people cannot get out of these things. But in life, there are other people that monstrously walk to their neighbors, their business neighbors, and start to gossip and start to unwind the positive relationships that someone has made one-on-one, as we do in networking for professional opportunities, for simply being regarded, for simply being not monstrously patronized, or I should say, harassed by business owners because an old guy needs to sit down. In life, there are moments of time to prove who we are in the house of God, and when you're loving and kind to someone, you really get the message. When you're not loving and kind, God will hit your life. I can promise you. Some people might say that my life was hit by God, and that's not true. My life was hit by people who were supposed to have loved me and didn't. My life was destroyed by a female person who didn't understand that her life impacted mine in such a significant way that I've been blessed by many times by the Lord. In life, we have moments of time to tell the truth of the story, and I'll be putting my story down not only in a second book on it, but also in a film, also in a screenplay, and also in a theatrical production. I want the world to know the story, and I want them to learn from the pain, the heartache, and the passion of a loving man. Thanks for listening.